Justin here with Outdoor Gladiators, joined by Matt and his son Peyton. We are stoked. Today is the day. Today is opening day of turkey.
Yep, got our decoy set up. We just got our blind situated. We're about 20 minutes into the season. It's 31 degrees out. It's a little cold. Peyton's already freezing, but he's going to stick it out as long as he can because he's the first shooter.
So. He's the first shooter. Are you stoked, man?
Yes.
He's ready to go. So we're going to start calling here in the next couple of minutes. Just stick with us. Gobbling, so we're still looking forward to seeing these little birds come out. We can hear them. We're starting to hear them get closer, so
should be popping out into the field anytime, I would imagine. Matt's been very responsive to the calls this morning. So
Matt's been inside. Yeah, Matt's been calling with his box call there, and shortly after he's done, you know, doing the call, you can hear him gobbling. So
very exciting.
It's very exciting.
cards. They were just Jake's. And Peyton wants a big Tom, so he held off. But we've got a really big Tom just on the other side of this hill. And he's working his way to us. All right. What happened?
I missed.
Are you sure? You might have hit him. He might be dead on the other side of that.
You didn't fly very aggressively.
No.
I gotta imagine you put something on him. I say we go up and walk and check.
Let's just give him a minute. Give him a minute. He might be over there dying. All right. So we just made a move on these birds. Obviously, you followed us as we got all the way over here. We had five Jakes come within 5 yards.
That was crazy.
Yeah, it was really cool. Peyton decided not to shoot, which is probably the right decision because we got some big toms out here. Well, I had him crawl out and stick his decoy in the ground because I knew there was a tom out there and I knew it would challenge him. And it did. He started fanning out and he started working his way right to us. And it got to the point where he was really close, but all we could see was his head sticking up. And I told Peyton, if you can see his head and you got a good shot, shoot him. He took the shot, maybe 25 yards. Then he popped up. He didn't go down right away, so I told him, shoot him again. And he popped a couple more rounds off, and it ended up running up over kind of over this crest of this hill here. So we're gonna give it a few minutes, and we're gonna go over there and check. And hopefully, we got a dead bird laying over there. So go for a walk with us, and let's go find some birds. Obviously shot at that. I'm pretty confident it was a miss. We've got several Jakes out here right now. As we were coming back, we had what we believed was a Tom right out in the field. So we did some belly crawling through the dirt. Got really dirty. And those birds ended up spooking and taking off on us. So we're hanging in there. We've got another bird off to our left side. It's trying to get through a chain length fence and it's just pacing back and forth, but we have a lot of bird activity right now. So what is it, about 9 o'clock, I think.
We're just gonna sit tight and hopefully a Tom comes out.
We're gonna start popping some Mountain Dews, get all jacked up, and we're gonna sit in this turkey blind and wait to smack something in the mouth. So,
all right. So we've had some birds that we've been calling at for a while. They've been gobbling behind us and they just came out into the field. They're about 100 yards. We got two decoys out. We got a hen and a tom decoy, and I think they're interested, but they're just kind of hanging out right now. So we might throw a call at them here in a few minutes. We're just going to watch these birds, be real careful, and we're going to, Peyton and I are going to try to double up right here. So,
are you ready, bud?
Yeah. Extremely excited.
Good, good. We're going to get one right. There we go.
I'm not going to miss it.
Oh, no, no. They're both Jakes.
Oh, dang it.
Yeah, that's okay. You can still call them in. It's good practice. Well, I guess that's good that didn't work out because those, we don't want to shoot them anyway.
Yeah.
Gosh, those, I wonder if those are different birds. Because those other two went into that.
You hear that?
Yeah. That was back here.
Oh, I thought it was that side.
Oh, it might have been.
This completes day one, opening day of turkey season. Peyton, describe your experience of your stalk there.
Oh, saw it quite a ways away, snuck up on it, got it pretty close. And
yeah, you took your time too, you were very patient.
Yep, did a great job.
It was intense, brought in some Jakes, and it was awesome. So
yep.
You continued to crawl out there and stuck it in there. What happened?
I got about like 7 more yards away. And I just shot right over his head.
I think you grazed it, to be honest. I think you grazed it.
I think I put a few rounds into his head, but just not enough for a kill.
So this
happens.
It happens. And the way you're positioned and I mean, you had a very small target. You only saw its head.
Right.
So, but this completes day one. It was a blast. It was intense, especially when the jakes came up. It was, I mean, they were like five yards or less.
Yep.
So we had a good day. We're going to be out here round two tomorrow, or day two tomorrow.
Yep.
We'll be out here, and just stick with us. See you tomorrow.
Day two of turkey opening weekend. We're already hearing gobbles to the west of us, so we're feeling good today. We already started calling. Yesterday there was a lot of action, so we're hoping for the same action this morning.
Absolutely, man. We are excited, although our energy level doesn't necessarily show. We're absolutely exhausted today. We're
pretty exhausted.
We put, I think, 8 to 9 hours in the blind yesterday with three different sits. We did a lot of walking, did a lot of stalking. And today's probably going to be no different. So stick with us. It's going to be a blast.
We'll see you guys here shortly.
They're getting closer.
I can hear them. I'm guessing probably about 200 yards.
Yeah.
250 yards. Definitely out in that tree line right there.
Yep.
So we were sitting here and we were just talking.
Oh, there's two more.
And all of a sudden, three toms just ran out. I got some good footage on the camcorder. But yet there seemed to be feeding. We used to call probably about a couple minutes prior that could have brought them out. But now there's five total toms out there. Unfortunately, they're heading to the north. We're kind of hoping that they would come to the south. Hopefully they turn around and they see the decoy and go for the hen. We're gonna sit tight and hoping for the best.
Hey, can you play up a second?
You wanna record this one?
Are they coming slowly?
Yep. Oh, yeah.
I walked out. Is that another town?
Oh, that's a hen. That's probably what's holding them up. They got a hen too close.
Fuck.
It's all right.
There's another tom that's in the back that's walking towards it.
Yep.
Well, I got on top of our little fortress over there, and I saw a couple of toms in the back corner over there, and we're going to try to go stalk them.
Sounds good.
You got the decoy.
Yeah.
Got your gun. You're all set to go, aren't you?
Yep.
We're going to kind of do what we did yesterday, kind of crawl up there.
Yeah.
Call them in.
Yep.
Sounds good, bud. Good luck.
We went on a stalk to find these birds, and we were looking out of this corner, and one of the hens popped out and then just bolted. Spooked the bird and ran back into the woods. So we're thinking about setting up on this field edge. We just threw our decoy out, because they've been trailing us like crazy. So we're just trying to make a move and figure these birds out. Alright guys, it's day two. I got set up a little while ago, and just kind of getting time to do my intro. Justin had to take off, it's his birthday, so he's going to go out and celebrate with some loved ones, some family and friends. So that just leaves me out here self-filming again. We've got a bunch of ducks out in the field. What time is it? It's got to be getting close to 7 o'clock or so. And I haven't had any turkey movement. I'm trying a new spot tonight. We've been seeing a lot of birds morning and evening running the edge of this field. So it's west of where we were originally sitting. So I figured I'd set up here and give it a try. I got a hen decoy out about 18 yards away. And ducks. We're just gonna kind of hope for the best. It's always tough self-filming, but it's a lot of fun too. So stick with me. We're gonna get a time on the ground.
Morning guys, day three over with Matt today over at his house, St. Louis. We're gonna set up a different spot today. We're gonna use some burlap over here on the west side. We've been seeing them come out there, so today we're gonna set up, we're gonna sit in the brush line and hopefully to see some birds today.
Dude, I'm excited. Every day that I've been out here, that I've been working and I can't hunt, I've been seeing toms come out of that exact same spot. There's a group of three that are pretty regular. They come out on the west side and then they'll head in on the south side. So I think either spot we set up, we're gonna be good. But we're gonna hit that west side and we're gonna see what happens.
Big toms, big toms.
We're ready to kill some birds.
We're ready, it's day three.
It's way too late in the season. We gotta get this done.
We gotta get it done. Let's do it. We're gonna head out there. We'll see you guys in a minute.
responsive at all.
That's not good.
Yeah, they usually quiet down this time of the day. Just striking out left and right this morning.
Went along the edge there, and I seen one hen, and she popped up, saw me, and ran right in there. Luckily, there was no Jakes or Toms in there that we would have scared off, but still.
I was just saying, we're striking out left and right this morning for as much activity as we had early. With all the gobbling, there's just been a huge lack of actual visual activity.
I think that gunshot early this morning.
Yeah, it's got them skittish.
It spooked them.
Yeah, I think they're in this thick stuff here. I think by tonight they'll be loosened up a little bit and they'll be moving around again, so.
You're gonna have a good night tonight.
I hope so.
All right, guys, this is the end of day three. Unfortunately, we didn't see really too many birds. Had a bunch of activity in the morning. Just didn't seem to come out.
Dude, tons of gobbling, tons of activity behind us, still the south of us. We did see a hen when we went for
Big
a walk.
Big Bertha.
Big, yeah, Big Bertha, we named her. I don't know, this is going to wrap up this video.
Yeah.
We hope you like it. If you liked it, smash that subscribe button, like, comment, let
share,
us know what you
share
think.
Share it around, you
share
know.
Share it around. We would appreciate the support.
Take care, guys.